We have stressed several times in this video the concept of getting to the bag early and being a stationary target. This is important for the middle infielders when turning a double play and for first basemen whenever they receive throws from other infielders. It is equally important for fielders covering a base on a steal attempt.
It's so much easier for a catcher to make an accurate throw when he's not trying to hit a moving target. In football, throwing to a receiver running a curl pattern is much easier than throwing to a receiver running at full speed across the middle. The same concept applies in baseball. Let's take a look at one of the most exciting plays in baseball, a steal attempt, and watch how the fielders cover their bases.
And then not have the result be good. The runner takes off, pitch swung on and missed, throw down, is in time, they got him. Durazo thrown out by Jason Varitek.
He's going. Throw down by Matheny. He is 0 for 1, and the inning is over.
We aren't going to have time to go over the catcher's mechanics and responsibilities in this video. We'll save that for a later DVD. But we will go out and receive some throws at the bag. So Cal, how's your arm feeling?
I'm ready, but only for the smaller field. Let's go out to Cal Senior's yard one more time.
Right now we're going to go over covering the bag on a steal. Okay, whether it's second base or whether it's third base, it really doesn't matter how we set up. Obviously, if somebody steals third base, the third baseman is covering. At second base, it's either going to be the second baseman or the shortstop covering the bag. But it's important to know that when we're covering the bag on a steal, number one, I've got to get to the bag early enough to be a good target for my catcher. I want to set up in a position where I straddle the base, and I want the ball to travel as long as it possibly can to the base. I want to catch it, come straight down, and straight back up. If I get to the base, and I set up in front of the base in this manner, and reach out here and catch the ball, there's no way I can catch the ball and move my arm back to the base as fast as that ball's traveling. It's one of the few times in baseball we actually let the ball get on you. But if I set up at the base in a straddle position, let the ball travel its full distance to the bag, let it get here, catch it, go straight down, straight back up, you're out. Thank you very much.
We'd like to communicate that a perfect throw, when the catcher throws the ball to the guy covering, is waist high. It's hard to actually catch the ball down. Sometimes you want to come up and make the tag. We want the ball right here waist high so we can catch it, take it straight down. So a perfect throw would be waist high. And in summary, the most important thing about covering on a steal is getting into this position, the straddle position, early enough where the catcher has not thrown the ball yet so that he can see you as a target. You can see the ball, the flight of the ball, where it's going to be. You can make a good judgment as a person covering the bag. You can say, okay, I'm anticipating a bad throw, so if the ball is off target, I can leave my position and block it and keep the runner here. If it's on target, let the ball fly, let the ball fly, let it get deep so you can catch it and put the tag straight down and get it back up, okay? The most important thing is get here early.
Now, at the youth levels, typically, right-hand hitter, second baseman's covering. Left-hand hitter, shortstop's covering. But we'd like to give you a little bit of knowledge here on what happens when you get to the professional ranks, and more importantly, at the big leagues, what actually goes on. I'm gonna go over my position at second, Cal's gonna go over to short. When we played together, Cal was in charge. He was the general of the infield, and he made determination on who was covering. At the big league level, what hitter? Not necessarily right or left, but just who it is. What pitcher? Does he have good control? Does he throw hard? What pitch selection? Is it a breaking ball? Is it a fastball? What runners on first base? All those things come into play at the big league level, and we make a determination who's going to cover the bag on a steal every single pitch. It's not just predetermined on the hitter, it's every pitch. So one example on how this would look is we're in our positions, we see the catcher put down his sign, the pitcher acknowledges, we know who's on first base, we say, okay, there's the sign, I'm looking at Cal. Cal gave me an open mouth. He opened his mouth like that. That means you. That's a simple way to do it. Okay, so I know right now when that pitcher picks his foot up and throws, and if that guy breaks, I'm beelining to second base to be a good target. There might be a different situation that comes up, and the catcher puts down his sign, pitcher acknowledges, we know who's on first base, we know who's hitting. I make a little glance to my shortstop. Cal gives me a, closed mouth that says me. He's got it. He knows when that pitcher picks up his foot and that runner breaks, he's got to beeline to second base and be the player to cover that. So at the big league level and professional ranks, we make a determination who covers second base on a possible steal or a possible hit and run every single pitch. Let's see if you guys can do that like big leaguers. Ah! Okay, shortstops and second basemen. Let's not pinch this bag and hurt it because I can't move if I'm like this. Let's get here. Let's set up wide. We need to be a wide setup here, okay?
Okay, here we go.
D-Rock! Yo! Yes! Tag him like you mean it. Yes! Yes! Yeah! That's a good tag.
You see this ball.
Yes! Straight down, straight up.
Yes!
Go.
Yes!
That's better.
Beautiful.
Yes! Catch it! Yes!
I give you the tough throws.
I need you all the way in this position. You're still kind of here. All the way here. I want this thing straddled this way. Down and up.
Oh!
Alrighty. Well, I think you guys are starting to look like big leaguers. Let's go on inside and hear what Cal has to say when he reviews this.
To induce, and then not have the result be good. The runner takes off, pitch swung on and missed. Throw down is in time to get him.
I think the lessons the kids learned here today